Is of the Beatles or the Nevers of Us. After that, the initial Muhammad. Goes through a successful end in the sense that Nevers of Us gives cognizance, recognizes the message and the meaning and the correctness of the message of the Rav Shlomo Kis. It submits to it, which is called Iskafia. Then comes the next stage. Except the next stage is not something that a human being can accomplish on his own. The next stage is where the Nefesh HaBamis becomes transformed, opens up to experience, not only to recognize, but to experience the godly spirit. This is a very profound transformation. Let us discuss this for a moment. In truth, why is it so impossible? The natural balance is also a divine creation. Why can it not be the reconnected, so to speak, to its origin, to its origin. The explanation to this is that we are not talking about connecting to its origin. It still draws life force from its source, from the universe. What we are talking about is that it should be cognizant of it, and that it should be able to process that information and live with it from its worldly stance, recognize godliness. That is really a revolution from the essence, complete opposite from turning it over. And bringing it to a completely different stance. Instead of recognizing its materials and where it is and how it understands things, it is going back to recognize. It should recognize the divine presence and the divine source from which it comes. And it should recognize it, utilizing its own functioning qualities, I would say, secular leaders. That is really a revolution. And as we have already discussed, and reiterate it and present it and see what is happening here. It is entirely natural for the Nefesh HaBamis to come to the world and say, okay, let me see what I see here. And let me understand my world from this, starting with this platform. This is in fact what has occurred and is still happening. What's called the Yehudim Chitzoni, secular worldly definition of reality. It's based on what we observe. And that we are very adept at doing. We can test it and prove it. So what's missing? What's missing is we are not recognizing that this worldly reality is not real in and itself. It does not make itself. This I mention all the time. We came up with such a fantastic idea. We evolved within ourselves. With this evolution, we became so great and so spiritual, so ridiculous. Where does the spirit come from? We were so proud of ourselves and our means of explaining all things that occur with us, we forgot a fundamental question. In order that there be that cognizance. That cognizance requires a transformation, a complete changeover in the orientation of Nefesh HaBa'ems. That my awareness and my knowledge is not based on what I examine and what I touch and feel. It is based on a source that is completely beyond me, that completely preceded my very existence. And even after that I came into existence, it does not, I still do not fully comprehend and fully relate to it. And in order to fully relate to it, I have to dig up from within myself. Because I am, after all, the divine creation. So deep down, I have that truth. I have to dig up that truth to recognize that my presence here is brought into existence by a supreme spirit. This is where I get my presence, this is where I get my inspiration and my koichos. No matter how much I will understand and be convinced that that is true, there is no way that I can reach out to that directly. And this is what we're talking about, he's saying, that this is effectuated by the source, by God Himself. He opens up our heart and enables us, allows us to see through and to actually to relate and to live at that with that spirit. This is called His Hapcha. It's like taking a garment. A garment has two sides. And turning it inside out. A garment it looks very beautiful, like one entity, one unit. with the sleeves and everything. But if you turn it inside out, you see that there are stitches and there are seams. It is not one entity. He has been made to that function, but he's been put together.
Welcome to IDT Connect. Please enter your conference ID. Welcome. Thank you. You are now entering the conference room. To exit the conference room, press **. For help, press *9. Participant number 2.
Uh-huh. Good thing I called it. This giving cognizance to the seams and the stitches that hold the garment together is unnatural. It is giving cognizance that this is, it was not born this way to serve me. It was made by someone. And it has to be maintained. And this someone who put it together is an expert at this. You have to have experience, you have to know how to do it. Even to recognize that yes, indeed, this beautiful garment really has to be maintained, and there were human beings who put it together. And even that requires a level of submission. And what is the end result? The end result is that he goes and buys material and goes to the tailor and he designs a garment from scratch. And he knows that this is not the way it was born. That there is talent and spirit that he was put into it. Just a very simple method of demonstrating the senior. The Nefesh HaBahamis must be brought to a point to recognize what is the basis of its existence. For that, he has to go through what's called a circumcision. Open up and see things from inside. And when you see things from inside, you see this is not self-contained, self-created entity. And in order to recognize that, you need the assist from above, from the creation himself, to help you get down to the bare bottom and recognize where this is all coming from. And this is called Milo, that is effectuated from above, and it's also called Re'usa Deliba. The heart recognizes. The mind can be fooled in this and that sense. It looks good. But the heart says, but it's not solid, it doesn't hold on its own. And therefore, there is what's called the Re'usa Deliba, the desire of the heart, that it's looking for something really solid, really basic. And this is Lamana Matamadas. This is not, reason does not bring it to that. This is just a self-cognizance. And this is called Hizhabcha Hashechon in Heir. But the darkness that was concealed is transformed and all of a sudden begins to shine. Okay, so let's start from the second line, Am Kuf Mem Nun Beis. which is the union that is expressed in the Pasuk, you go out to war. But what is the ultimate result of this war is, Hashem renders the enemy into your hand. Rak, except, even though that ultimately it is Hashem's effect, Hashem's creation doing, nonetheless, in order to be granted to have this gift, first there has to be Kisei, you have to venture out to war. Bekoyach atzmi, to your own power. Kama sheyochel, to whatever extent he can, lifel by nefesh abans, to affect in the nefesh abans. He has to face up to the nefesh abans. He has to confront the nefesh abans. To whatever extent he is able to affect it with his own koyches. And we'll see in a moment why we need this initial stage. But they say, and as a result of that, achar kach, afterwards, once you are confronting those abamis, you yourself see that you have to, yourself want to affect a change in those abamis. Then, unusone avay lekecho biyodecho, then avay lekecho renders him in your hand. And the real reason, the real reason why there has to be the initial confrontation with your own capability is, if you think about it, you'll realize that if there is not the initial confrontation on your own, when it comes, you don't know what to make of it. You can't relate to it. It's like you're blindfolded and you transformed. You know that there should be a real transformation. That you should have this transformation and yet remain an entity in the world. You have to have the initial confrontation on your own. And then when this opens up and you render it and you're getting hold of it, you understand, you can relate to it. You know, oh, this is what I was looking for. You have to confront Nefesh HaBa'amis on your own, and then there could be Anton Avay Lekecho, and then when it's rendered to your head, by Hashem to your head, there is a full benefit of that rendering. At the end of the third line, Bezehu Gan Kein, and this too explains the principle, the Hagiluyim the Elo of Rosh Hashanah, that all the revelations and all recognitions that occur that happened in Elul, Rosh Hashanah, Tluyim, are really dependent on the Aved of the Chol Hashanah. They are dependent on the Aved of throughout the year. If there is no Aved throughout the year, then the Giluyim, that which is presented to you on Rosh Hashanah,
You are now entering the conference room. To exit the conference room, press **. For help, press *9. Participant number 2.
Okay, we're back. And this is why that the Aved of the Giluy, that which is revealed and given to you on Erev Rosh Hashanah, it really is completely dependent on the Aved of Chatuah Deir. The whole fourth line in the end of the third line. The whole hashono, because throughout the year, iker ho aveda he became b'meichule. The principle of aveda is with b'meichule, in other words, with a conscious effort, conscious means of understanding what's going on and how and what is life about and what is aveda Hashem about. The Haino Apitam Vadas, which means Apitam Vadas based on the principles of reason and knowledge. Knowledge means I recognize where I am, I know what I'm doing. And I'm constantly digging and trying and making an effort to break through all the barriers. Ulfi Ere Ho Aveido B'chol Hashon. And in proximity, in relative, to how the Aveda throughout the year occurs, how deeply the Aveda throughout the year happens and so forth, according to that, Noishnim Be'elul Rosh Hashanah, he is rendered, he is given. And Elul Rosh Hashanah V'aseresim Eitshuva, he is Galus Etzem Hanshomo. The coming forth, and the opening up and revealing of the essence of the neshama. What is the essence of the neshama? What is the neshama about? Which is not something which can be identified with seichel, but it's given to him. But it's given only if the seichel is prepared to accept it. Because he had every effort throughout the year to get to something true. So when he comes, he says, aha, this is what this is, I understand what this is about. Okay, so we are now on the line that begins with Galus Etzem Hanshomo, which is the sixth line from the top. In the middle, Bezehu, and thus this is the meaning of the pasuk. Kitzeis el ha-milchom, when you venture out to war. Which means that there has to be, it requires to venture out from inside. Inside is, as we said before, the makif. I recognize the truth, not with my own seichel means, because that's the prevalent, that the reality itself. And are comfortable in it, but you have to venture out. Venture out means lavid avidose bitfilo, to do his aveda bitfilo in through davening. And what's davening? Davening that which describes and identifies all the things, all the godly effect on the world from a worldly perspective. Apitam v'das. On the basis as described, the Pitam Vadas as described with Pitam Sechel, Pitam observation. When we see the sun rise in the morning, we see the cycle of the world, and we see the four cycles of the seasons and so forth, all that identify the Sechel. And so this is something which is affected, it's created. And it's intentionally created. And the mountains and the valleys and the rivers and the oceans and the lakes, this is all created in order to be a complete world. And lahavdil, all the animals, once you begin to recognize that what you are observing is a creation. This is the mechola. You venture from out, from inside, and you say, oh, there's a big world outside, but where does this come? Ah, this is the same creator that created that internal truth. And then you begin to identify it with that venture, with that perspective. All the wonders that you're observing in the world, you begin to recognize these are divine wonders. These are not natural. wonders. The very fact, all the laws of nature, all the laws of physics, the very fact that things fall down, all the laws, everything, the gravity and all that is a divine creation. In order to create a wholesome world, in order that ultimately this world will be able to represent to the human being the Godly presence. When rain comes and rain comes down with a full force, this is part of what we expect in davening. And this was in davening, we described the entire natural presence and cycle. And it is imperative that the whole idea is to reflect on it with our seichel, so that we begin to recognize there is something greater in this reality that we are experiencing. And then when that greatness is being revealed to us, that really there's a divine spirit behind all that, then we are prepared to accept it. But first, this original process, this has the effect of to affect the beetle in Nefesh HaBamis. You have to venture out from the makifim, from being contained in the makif, and come out into open world. And in that open world, recognize what's happening here. So the Nefesh HaBamis itself becomes affected, perplexed. Says, what is happening? From its own venture point, from its own vantage point, he begins to see there's something unique, you know, something great happening here. Shalidei zeh dafka, only as a result of this process and this effort, Nase Yisrein Oyer. It brings about the Yisrein Oyer, the supremacy, the extra quality in Oyer. The extra quality in Oyer is not represented, is not brought forth through the Makif. The extra quality of Oyer is brought forth by opening up and breaking through the world, the structure itself. This brings out the Yisrael Oyer. Ein Eim Imtzei, that's what you say to the Chava. Ein Eim Imtzei. The term "say go out" is not suitable. Elo the Misha Shoy Bifnim, only to one who is essentially Bifnim inside. Shoy Bifnim means that he's resting. He's at house. He's comfortable inside. He belongs inside. And then this stuff that belongs inside, we tell him, okay, it's time to step forward. What is this internal that belongs inside? Hainu, this is HaKoyach HaZeh. Means that the Koyach HaZeh, the ability to process and to recognize the Eastern Nation and to confront the Nefesh HaBamis in its world is Mehamakifim Sheh B'Nefesh. It is actually the Koyach is drawn from the Makifim Sheh B'Nefesh. The Makifim, the super qualities of the Nefesh. That meaning that is not worldly at all. It is aloof from world. Does not recognize what world is all about. And this makitum shibenefesh, this is where the power and the ability to confront the worldliness and the nefesh habam is, and ultimately to reveal and recognize the yisrin oyer, the superior quality of oyer, is due to makitum. Looking at it from a top-down vantage point. Rak accept shezeru behel. Except that this cognizance is behel. It's concealed. Concealed means you see it from a macro perspective, but you don't really reveal it on a worldly level. The worldly means what it is. V'yachar kach. But then afterwards, after this confrontation, and after all the effort that is invested in this confrontation, then there is a divine gift. This is something which is actually a power not even from the nefesh. Only Havai Lekecha, only Hashem can effectuate this type of thing. In other words, this ultimate victory is not even something that you can say, account, how did I get to it? You don't know how you got to it.